In this video, we're continuing on with the Exponential's Functions worksheet on the KutaSoftware website under the Algebra 1 section. Picking up where we left off with number 7, we're going to be sketching the graph. Our function is f of x is equal to 1 half times 3 to the x. Now note that this x is positive and our base is indeed a whole number. So our exponential function is going to look something like this. Where as we increase in the x direction, we're also increasing in the y direction. Which means, as we decrease in the x direction, that function is getting closer and closer to zero. So in number 7, we'll pick a few values for x and then solve for f of x. So I'll pick negative 2, 0, and then 2 to start. So we're doing f of negative 2, f of 0, and f of positive 2. Well, if we plug negative 2 in, f of negative 2 is equal to 1 half times 3 to the negative 2, which is 1 half times 1 over 3 squared. And that's equal to 1 over 2 times 9, which is 18. So f of negative 2 is 1 over 18. F of 0, 1 half times 3 to the 0, which is 1 half times 1, which equals 1 half. And then finally, f of 2, positive 2, is 1 half times 3 squared, which is 9 over 2, 9 halves. Now I'll plot each of these points in order to sketch my graph. When x is negative 2, y, or f of x, is 1 18th. So very close to that x-axis. When x is 0, y is 1 half. And then when x is 2, y, or f of 2, is 9 halves, which is 4.5. Let's plot one more point. Let's look at when x is 3. When x is 3, we'll have f of 3, and that's equal to 1 half times 3 to the third. So that's going to be 27 over 2, since 3 to the third is 27, and 27 times 1 half is 27 over 2. And in decimal form, that's 13.5, or 13 and a half. So then we'll go 3, and then 13 and a half. Now I'll connect those to form my graph. So there's my graph in number 7. Now let's look at number 8. Now, in number 8, our base is a fraction. So that's the same as saying 5 times 2 to the negative x. So as opposed to increasing y values as we increase x, our graph is going to look like this. We're going to decrease y values as we increase x values. So making our xy table, or x f of x table, our t chart, I want to start first when x is equal to 0. So we're going to be finding the y-intercept. Now remember, when x is 0, that would be 2 to the 0, which is always 1. So whatever is multiplied to that base and exponent, that will be the y-intercept. So note that if we look back at number 7, 1 half was the y-intercept because 3 to the 0 was 1. So looking at number 8, 5 will be the y-intercept because 2 to the 0 is 1. So when x is 0, f of 0 is equal to 5. So 0, and then we can plot 5. Now let's pick a couple other points. Let's look at when x is negative 1. F of negative 1 is equal to 5 times 1 half to the negative 1, which is 5 times 1 half to the negative 1 is equal to 2. So 5 times 2 is 10. So when x is negative 1, f of x is 10. Now let's pick another point to the left, let's say negative 2. F of negative 2, we'll have, so as opposed to looking at this original equation, let's look at the equation that is equivalent. So plugging in negative 2, I'm going to have 5 times 2 to the opposite of negative 2, which is 5 times 2 squared. since the opposite of a negative is a positive. 2 squared is 4, and 5 times 4 is 20. So negative 2 in the x and positive 20 in the y. Now let's look what happens when we plug 2 in for x. So we're going to have the function of 2, and that's equal to 5 times 2 to the negative 2, or 5 times 1 half squared. So 5 times 1 half squared is 1 over 2 squared, so that's 5 over 4, or 5 fourths, which is 1 and 1 fourth. So when x is 2, y is 1 and a quarter. And let's pick one more point. Let's look at when x is equal to 4. F of 4 is going to be equal to 5 times 2 to the negative 4th, or 5 times 1 over 2 to the positive 4. That's 5 over 2 to the 4th, which is 5 over 16, which in decimal form is 0.3125. So when x is 4, y is 0.3125, 5 sixteenths. Now I can sketch my graph to see what my exponential function will be. And that's my exponential function in number 8. Now for 9 and 10, we're to write an equation for each graph. So our exponential function is in the form of f of x is equal to some constant times some base to the x. And our x can be either positive or negative depending on the slope of the line. So in number 9, as x increases, y is also increasing, so f of x is going to be equal to a times b to the x. In number 10, when x is increasing, y is decreasing, so this is going to be in the form of f of x equals a times b to the negative x, or we can think of it as a times 1 over b to the x. So let's focus on number 9. In number 9, we can see that our y-intercept, so when x is 0, we cross that y-axis at 1 half. So our a value is going to be 1 half, because f of 0 is equal to 1 half. So f of 0 equals 1 half times b to the 0, which is 1. So for f of x, we have f of x equals 1 half times, now we need our b value. Well, let's look at another point. When x is 1, y is 2.5. So f of 1 equals 2.5. So we can say that 2.5 equals 1 half of some b value, our base value, to the first. Since x is 1, b to the 1 is equal to b. So all we need to do is multiply both sides by 2 in order for that 1 half to cancel out, and that'll give us that b is equal to 2 times 2.5, which is 5. So f of x equals 1 half times our b value now is 5, and our variable is x. So f of x equals 1 half times 5 to the x. So again, going over the steps, we first locate that y-intercept, which will be that constant a that gets multiplied to our exponent value. Once we knew what a was, we picked another point to plug in f of x and x in order to solve for b. Then we had our exponential function. Let's do the same in number 10. In number 10, our y-intercept occurs at 0, 2. So for f of 0, that function equals 2. So 2 equals a times b to the 0, therefore 2 equals a. So we'll have f of x equal to 2 times, now we have to figure out our b value, or our fraction. The next point we can use is 1, 1. When x is 1, y is 1. So for f of 1, our function at x equals 1 is also equal to 1. So that means that 1 is equal to our a value times our b value in fraction form, 1 over b, to the first. So that's 1 equals 2 times 1 over b. So in order to isolate my term 1 over b, I'll divide both sides by 2, So I'll get that 1 half is equal to 1 over b. So I can either solve for b or I can solve for 1 over b. So if 1 over b is equal to 1 over 2, then b is 2. So I'll have f of x equals 2 times 1 half, which is 1 over b, to the x. And remember, if I was to solve for b, I would get that 2 equals b. So I could also write this as 2 times 2 to the negative x. However, f of x equals 2 times 1 half to the x will allow us to write that x as a positive exponent, which is the form we want to write it in. So f of x, or y, is equal to 2 times 1 half to the x. So y equals 2 times 1 half to the x. And with that, we wrap up this worksheet. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. And if you need any further explanation, go to my tutorial section where I go over exponential functions more in depth. And if you haven't already, like, subscribe, and share.